Lady Master Leto says, first of all, that the beautiful meditation that we've created with the ladies' voices is a wonderful opportunity to leave our bodies at night through our souls and experience the heaven world, to interact with the masters, the angels, divine beings, and to return in the morning refreshed, invigorated, and ready to meet the day's challenges. And that we can also use this anytime that we feel a little maybe discombobulated and we would like to just go into meditation and actually consciously leave our body in order to be rejuvenated by angels who love us and would like to nurture our souls with this little time of about, it's only what, 15 minutes long or so, this time of respite from the cares of the world, the emotions, the emotional energy of the world, the turbulence of this world, enter into that divine energy field, and then to come back with this activation of our higher centers that occurs in the retreats in the heaven world, we can then move forward with great joy and love in our hearts and meet those challenges that we may still have to meet, yet we have the tools, the resources to deal with them. So let us play Leto's evening meditation now, even though it's morning, and enter into the heaven world and consider maybe what you feel that you require from God today as a little boost in order to receive it and then use the momentum of it to meet your day's challenges and opportunities and to move forward. So here we go with Leto's evening meditation.
Leto's Evening Meditation.
Angels will show you the way. the evening angels who escort my soul to heaven, I pray. I am a being of pure white light, clothed in the holy radiance of my divine presence and the effulgence of the virtues and quintessences of my source. I live and move and have my being in a living, liquid crystal diamond of light. I am free and clear and ready to soar to cosmic heights, to the sacred retreats of the universal great white brotherhood, in the crystal cities of God, in the etheric realms of light. Beloved Archangel Michael and your escort angels, receive my soul and safeguard it along with my body temple while I sleep this night. I am prepared to learn all that I require in my spiritual education and for my service to life tomorrow. I am secure in the arms of my Lord and sealed in the embrace and the grace of God to complete my cosmic assignments this night on behalf of souls throughout the world. Beloved Leto, tutor me to swiftly and safely journey in my finer bodies to my assigned place in heaven. Angels of rejuvenation and of the resurrection flame, revivify my four lower bodies and seal them in sheaths of God glory and blue and white light during my sacred journey tonight. This which I call forth for myself, I call forth for all light bearers and heart friends in all worlds throughout the cosmos. Amen. Thank you for the gift of flight. We are grateful for your love as we fly to realms above. Angel escorts, help us to fly on rays of light with you. To the skies each night we rise, soaring now, ascending high. Angel escorts, clear our way so that we may study, pray in the crystal cities bright with our master friends each night. Angel escorts, seal us now, as to beings great we bow. Master teachers, welcome us to tonight's most precious class. Angel escorts, beings bright, thank you for your help this night. As our body temples sleep, we know you our souls will keep. We work with you, blessed Leto dear. Flowing cosmic radiance in our hearts appear. Teach us now your sacred science, let it be our norm. As our souls arise with thee from our human form, let our spirits soar and fly into realms of light, sacred schools of mastery, havens shining bright. Blessed retreats above the earth, crystal temples tall, where our inner teachers live, holy beings all. Masters, angels, precious friends, we believe in you. Cosmic education flows, dreams of light ensue. Help us keep the memory of all that has transpired. When our bodies wake each morn, keep us all inspired. Leto, blessed teacher dear, we surrender all. Grace us with your emerald light, answer now our call. Hail Leto, Seal my soul this night, O Lord, by your angel's flaming sword. Now your light shines over me. I am safe, my spirit free. I discover as I rise treasures far beyond the skies. Now my heart and soul take flight as I visit schools of light, study with the masters there, feel their tender loving care, learn my lessons quickly well, all my tutor has to tell. Know each concept's depth and worth to transform and give rebirth. Rigid patterns now release as I grow in inner peace. Heed each opportunity to expand the light in me. Then upon my soul's return, and awakened in the morn, live with greater passion, love, purpose quickened from above. Seal my soul, O Lord, this night, in your heart and in your light.
May the wings there enfold you.
Beloved Leto says that when we leave our bodies consciously and go to the retreats, we can have an acceleration of the return to us of soul parts that we have lost in past lifetimes and in this life through anger, through violence, causing pain and suffering to others, through disconnectedness by doing things and having habit patterns that are not in alignment with our presence. When we are divided within ourselves by focusing on something less than God or the divine, it creates wedges in our psyche, in our subconscious, in our unconscious. And so to heal these wedges and situations where we have lost aspects of our true nature, by surrendering them to forces of darkness, entities, demons, discarnates, fallen angels, we have to have a greater magnet of fire within our being. And we can call for the great central sun magnet to be placed over us. We can enter into a great connection with God through divine love, loving the Lord our God with our entire heart, mind, strength, and soul. This creates a sacred flow field and like a flame field of light that is so powerful that it naturally then allows those soul parts to come back to us. We can use Ho'oponopono, which is a key to the return of soul parts. We can enter into the forgiveness flame as a living reality, giving that prayer, I am forgiveness acting here 70 times 7, as Jesus told us to forgive 70 times 7. And when we forgive and forget and transmute, cause, effect, record, and memory, then naturally those aspects of self that we have let go of or surrendered will return to us very gracefully. They will be returning as if on with little wings of light, as the angels glory in that alchemy and miracle of the return of these soul parts. The greatest action to have them return is through divine love, because it was anti-love that sent these soul parts away. Anger, hatred, reactivity, negativity, etc. And so what do we do to counteract that or countermand it? We invoke the opposites of the negativity, which is the positivity, the positive ion of our I Am God presence, and see, feel, know, and directly experience union with God. Because in that state of union with God, we are true to ourselves, and we can't then be untrue to another. And it is in these untruths toward others that we have lost aspects of ourself. They have been stolen from us, yet we really surrendered them. They can't be stolen from us unless we have consciously let them go by surrendering them through states of awareness that were less than ideal and the ideal of our I Am presence. So Leto says that we can gain greater physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual health through the return of soul parts that we have lost, because when they're reintegrated within us, we are whole. And it may take some time for us to reintegrate them fully. And when we do, we will feel better. We will feel that we have this greater magnet to then magnetize more of God into our lives, more love, more light, more energy, more virility, more divine stability. So if you have issues with your health and vitality. Leto says, work on the remagnetization to yourself of your lost soul parts, because you are not yet an integrated being fully in God by a lack of having these aspects of yourself that have been let go of or surrendered. And when you have them returned to you and kind of like a reverse surgery reintegrated, you are more whole, and then you can make right choices. You can enter into divine relationships with people. You interact with people at a very high level of vibration rather than a low level of vibration. You will magnetize friends to yourself who are your true spiritual friends, compatriots, and those who resonate with you at a higher level of vibration, including the ascended masters, of course, and our angels and our divine guides. They will be so clear around you that you will begin to feel their presence more, even see them or experience aspects of their awareness, which are there always to support you, guide you, help you. If you find that you don't have a lot of friends in the physical, why is that? There are aspects of yourself which people avoid because you are not yet whole. And so if you can't maintain a relationship with someone of the opposite sex that you are hoping to have, why is that? Because you are not yet whole. And so you have to work on your psychology. And the best way to work on your psychology is to return to God. Return to God by allowing all the godly aspects of yourself to be reintegrated into you and through you and within you. And then those that are of the highest order of your divine friends in human form or from the heaven world will naturally desire to be around you and to interact with you and to not feed off of you, but to bask in the light of who you are as a God-realized one. So self-assess, Leto says, to see how integrated you are and how you can sense yourself and your divine self-fullness, not selfishness, but self-fullness. In other words, you are full and rich in the divine selfhood that is part of your goal. And then do those spiritual practices that allow you to feel that wholeness, feel that unity field of beingness, feel the sense of being in God and godly and whole and even holy. Many of our lost relationships that we've had in past lives are because there was a disjointed situation that occurred where we could not reconcile something within a relationship that then caused a schism and a little aberrant energy field within our psyche and our memory body and the memory body within our emotional body, Leto says. So there are memories within the emotional body of reactivities and situations that have occurred where we have felt devalued or unappreciated or in some way not known as the way we feel we know ourselves to be. And so to heal these little aberrant psychological cracks in our energy field at a very subtle vibration is important. And as we work on our inner children, our inner child, but the inner child is composed of many children, aspects of father, mother, brother, sister, and cousins, uncles, aunts, etc., nephews, nieces, all of these little aspects of self that are kind of moving around in our psyche, we can have the resolution of every relationship we've ever had that has not been whole and pure and divine. And as we now begin to treat others as we desire to be treated, remember the golden rule. This is, Leto says, a key to relationships. Consider how you desire to be understood, known, revered even as a godly one, and revere the other person as the same, as a godly being, as a divine creature, as a holy person. Revere everyone that way, whether you know them on the outer or not, very well. And by revering others with this holy reverence, you naturally magnetize to yourself that same energy that you revere others with. It is karmic law. It is divine law. How you treat others, how you behold others, how you feel about others, how you talk about others, directly impacts your vital field of your energy and your aura. And if you gossip, don't think that you can maintain perfect health. You know, every gossip, whether it's a big gossip with a big G or a little gossip with a little G, did you hear about this person? That's a little gossip. If it starts getting into criticism, condemnation, and judgment, it becomes a big G. And then guess what? You have the descent of the energy of that CCJ directly upon you. And it impacts your health. It impacts your vitality. It impacts how you view yourself subconsciously when you criticize others. I've heard lately, even from very high initiates, little subtle things that are disturbing to me because we have to remind ourselves of Melchizedek's teaching. And if you haven't heard it or you would like to hear it again, please find that teaching, hear it again, because how we talk about others, especially servitors within our movement, directly impacts us, our own energy. So if you find that you're getting sick a lot, or you find that you just don't feel at your highest peak of performance, or you feel a lack of appreciation from others or love or whatever it is, it all starts with you. It all ends with you. It is your choice how to behold others as divine. Even when you have little disagreements and work situations or whatever, you know, we can't let those little things become big things to the point where it impacts an entire community. It impacts how we address people, how we think of them, and the patterns that go on through our emotional and mental bodies. We have to practice what we preach in terms of holding the Immaculate Concept. And if we, instead of gossiping or talking with even a little wisp of negativity about another, if we pray for them instead, we know that the effects will be positive and beneficial both to that person and to ourselves. We will feel better about everything. And guess what? That person will also have the wherewithal to maybe, if they've been a little bit out of alignment with their own presence, or down in the dumps, or feeling a little gray, I won't say blue because blue is good, but gray, it will help them. Our prayers, our support of them spiritually and emotionally will actually help to heal the issue. And they can rise out of states of lack of God's self-awareness, and they will be a better person, and we will be the better for it because we help them by holding that Immaculate Concept. Now, Leto says that holding the Immaculate Concept requires a great amount of love. It's not just a visionary thing. It's loving and revering that person as a godly person. And the more energy of love we put into holding the Immaculate Concept, the greater the power of that image will be on behalf of that person. And it always starts with us. So if we can't hold the immaculate image of ourselves, how can we hold it for another? It's like we have to love ourselves as God loves us before we can love others truly and fully. So we have to first hold this ideal and divine image of ourselves as pure, undefiled, godly, masterful, etc. And then we can do the same for everyone because we're all one anyway. So as we do it to the Christ, we do it to all. Jesus said, you know, whatsoever you've done unto these little ones, you've done unto me. That was the law of oneness and an understanding that we are all connected. Not everybody gets it, But those who love others as Jesus loved, with this pure, undefiled love, this truly Christian love, which is a Christic love, they understand these dynamics to the point where they live it as a reality, and they do not harbor any negativity toward any person. Yes, there will be little reactions, and we can't say that we won't have little troubles in our relationships with others. Yet how much do we hold on to those, regurgitate them, and keep them within ourselves as a little memory that troubles us? You know, it troubles us more than it troubles the other person, because it keeps us in this troubling vibration where we don't feel good about ourselves, because we've now continued to harbor this subconscious or very subtle CCJ of another. It's very destructive for initiates to do this. And the more subtle it is, the more diabolical, Leto says. We have to root it out. We root it out through love, through the cherishment of ourselves and others with a pure love that is so powerful that it anoints everything in its sacred wake. Pure love anoints with light, Leto says. And I desire that each one of us anoints others with this sacred love, this sacred light field of reverence, understanding, beneficence, and all of the virtues of God. I've been desiring to share this type of teaching, and I'm grateful that Leto is here today to offer it, because the clearer we are in our psyche, the easier it is to leave our body at night and go to the retreats, the more profound, deep, and healing sleep we will have at night to restore ourselves. Because there is a restoration that occurs when we are still through sleep. And you may not think of it as an aspect of stillness, Leto says, when we sleep, but we are, as a whole, pretty still, right? I mean, we do move around a little bit in our bodies, but it's an opportunity to enter into a type of stillness within silence that is very healing, very healing. And what does that stillness and silence afford? It gives God the opportunity to refashion us and to heal us and to restore us to our own divine nature. And so we require that sleep. And when we don't have enough sleep, it's hard to live in the integrity of our true self. So sleep, and a deep, deep sleep in the presence of angels and God and the masters, is so important for every initiate. And lest we think that we should work to the point of not getting sleep, very few individuals on the earth are able to live at that level. There are masters who can do that because they have mastered themselves to the point where they don't require the sleep. Yet 99.7% of humanity requires that, and probably even more. So let us allow ourselves the required sleep that we truly need in order to live in love, live in the integrity of wholeness. Because if we can't be whole, how can we help others be whole? We have to be whole first. And so to be whole, we require that sleep. So when you feel that your body is telling you, your body elemental is telling you, I require more sleep, and it's a true requirement, not a false requirement, then use that opportunity. And what Leto says is go to bed earlier. I went to bed about 8:30, 9 o'clock last night, woke up early, yet I had a deep, deep 6 hours of sleep that was very, very healing. And I had mystical experiences, and I woke with great, great love in my heart. And sometimes just going to bed an hour earlier is very important for many of us who may require that extra little boost to get over, you know, a problem with our body, maybe a tiredness or a sense that there's something encroaching on our true health and vitality. Maybe we feel we're starting to come down with a cold or the flu or a virus has set in or bacteria or whatever it is. Go to bed, drink plenty of liquid, and do what you have to do. And give Leto's evening meditation as we just did. Did you feel the difference in your, both in your body, but also your psyche as we gave this? I felt a very deep healing energy within the subtle aspects of my emotional body. And I think that having the women's voices, the beautiful feminine aspect of God that Leto really truly represents overshining this meditation is very soothing, very comforting to our psyche, to our soul. And we require that comfort. You know, life is not always easy. So this is Leto's teaching. I really appreciate it. Thank you, beloved Leto. And I think that, you know, eventually we'll memorize all of these words and all these prayers and songs, because when we get a momentum on giving this at night, and as she said, whenever we feel that we require leaving our body and just going into heaven, I think we're going to be the better for it. It's going to really help us to maintain that comfort flame manifesting through us all the time to help others.